Cursor 1.0 dropped today, and they have some big news. I'm a big fan of Cursor, and I've been using it for over a year. It has been a huge productivity and creativity boost for me, and I've been able to bring some ideas to life with much less hassle. Now, after several versions starting with 0.x, they have finally released their version 1. And there's a lot to be excited about, so let's take a look at what's new. First up is BugBot, an AI code review bot for your pull requests. To enable it, you go to your Cursor settings, connect with your GitHub account, and you're ready to go. BugBot is essentially an AI assistant for your pull requests. It can review your code and leave comments. You can configure when it should run and when it shouldn't run, and there is a Fix in Cursor button that takes you back to Cursor and auto-populates your chat window. Next update is Background Agent. I haven't personally used Background Agent yet, and it seems that it was around for a while, but now it's enabled for everyone. Background Agent basically edits your code and runs it in a remote environment. It will clone your repo, start making the edits you have requested, and at any time you can check on the agent to see how it's doing, request more updates, or make it stop. Another new beta feature is memories. Memories are essentially cursor rules, but they're based on the conversations from your chat. These are automatically generated by Cursor itself. So if you want to try them out and see if it works in your workflow, you need to go to settings, then rules, and enable generate memory settings. Next up is OneClick MCP Setup. MCPs are huge in Cursor, and now the installation just got easier. If you're developing an MCP server yourself, there's now an add to Cursor deep link that you can include on your website to enable one-click installation in Cursor. So from now on, you'll probably be able to find an MCP on the internet, click add to Cursor, and start using it. This simplifies the installation process where you previously had to edit the JSON file and put in the installation instructions yourself. And now my favorite feature, Mermaid Diagrams. Cursor now comes with support of Mermaid Diagrams, which it renders directly in the chat. These are great for various reasons. As a tester, this gives me a great overview of different scenarios, and it can be a starting point for creating test automation. But it's also excellent for documenting your application and looking for any gaps in logic. The possibilities are endless, and Cursor now supports them natively. Besides all of these exciting features, Cursor has now revamped their dashboard and settings, which now look more polished. You can now view your usage and cost breakdowns by tool or model, run network diagnostics, and much more. That covers the major updates in Cursor 1.0. Hope you all like this. Happy coding, everyone.